than the 5 minute probability on Bobby Duncan, a race out down third. Boxing returns to Madison Square Garden with tonight's 10 rounder between former weatherweight champion Luis Rodriguez of Miami and undefeated middleweight contender Wilbert Skeeter McClure of Toledo, Ohio. The 24-year-old McClure, a graduate of the University of Toledo with an AP in education, has spent the last 2 years in the U.S. Army. A stylist with moves reminiscent of Ray Robinson, McClure has won all 14 professional bouts, scoring 6 knockouts. As an amateur, he won national AAU, Golden Glove, and Olympic titles. The 26-year-old Rodriguez won and lost the welterweight title in 2 controversial bouts with Emil Griffith this year. Fighting a middleweight as he is tonight is nothing new. Recently, he registered the first KO of Denny Moore's career, and he has victories over Joey Giamba, Yama Bahama, and Gene Ace Armstrong. Rodriguez shows 51 victories, 3 losses by decision, 2 no contests, and 22 KOs. Rodriguez stands 5 feet 9, McClure 5'11 and a half. At the commission weigh-in, McClure was 159 and a quarter, Rodriguez 150 and a half. In just a moment, we'll bring in the 10-round middleweight bout between Luis Rodriguez and Wilbert Skeeter McClure. It's welcome home here at Madison Square Garden, and we welcome back Johnny Addy. John?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, something about next week's show here at Madison Square Garden. No boxing will be televised all over the country next Friday night. There will be no televised show. Here is a show, one of the best of the year, brings together two outstanding middleweight contenders, Joey Yachts of New York, and Reuben Harry Kane Carter of Patterson, New Jersey. 10-round feature. Also, two other big 3-round bouts will be on the card, plus the usual preliminaries. Now, tickets are on sale at the box office now. Get your tickets early because we expect a big crowd for one of the outstanding bouts of the season. And talking about boxing, every Tuesday night there's boxing at Sunnyside Golf. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to meet one of the top contenders for the heavyweight title from Chicago, Illinois, Eddie Tunnell. Friday night, November the 15th. Recent conquer of the world heavyweight champion, Willie Pistano. He will make his debut here in New York. Gregorio Peralta. Gregorio Peralta.
Thank you.
I'm going to continue my play.
In other words, if it drops
down, even though the line is
not
open to,
you get up. And you stay down in the air, and you knock down. So put up the board, you shake it.
Scoring here in New York on the rounds basis with a supplementary point system. If the rounds come out even, the mandatory 8 count is in effect if a man is scored. If he is scored 3 times in a round, he loses by knockout, and his territory to the 10 count, if necessary, is continued after the bell has rung, even including the last round. Luis Rodriguez, who dotes on middleweights, the White Trunks, Wilbert, Skeeter McClure, and the biggest effort of his career at the Black Trunks. Rodriguez likes to move in. McClure likes to move in, but McClure is letting Rodriguez move in and is countering well. Thank you. up to round four of a dandy Friday night fight at the Garden. Luis Rodriguez, white trunks, Wilbert McClure in black. McClure came through with a lot of poise after being on the deck last round. Landed some real good ones himself.
Good one.
6th of a 10-rounder at Madison Square Garden this Friday night. On the right-hand side, Logan McClure and Ms. Luis Rodriguez. Two of black trunks, Rodriguez and White. One knockdown so far. Rodriguez at McClure down. At this point, McClure down.
Thank you.
Chicago won a split decision over Clyde Taylor. Little from Brooklyn, Taylor from the Bronx. Mike White had a split decision for Jose Colon of New York over Shepard Colon of Puerto Rico. And in a four-round rubber bait bout, Carl Williams of Newark won a split decision over Jesus Como of Puerto Rico. Here's round nine. Luis Rodriguez, White Bronx, Wilton McClure, White Bronx. Thank you. finish. There's the bell. It's all over. It was a good one, wasn't it? We'll have the decision in just a minute. For the commissioners, Frank Morris and Alvin Erickson, to go over the cards in the right-hand corner. That's the corner where McClure is right now. The youngster, win or lose, fought a fine fight against the toughest man he has met so far. McClure, up to tonight, has won all 14 of his professional fights. Luis Rodriguez won and lost the welterweight title this year with Emil Griffith. That's Frank Morris and Alvin Erickson, and they are going over one more card brought to them by Johnny Addy, scoring on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system here in New York State. Rodriguez was penalized the sixth round for striking low. However, the chances are McClure had won that round anyway. McClure was down for an eight count in the third round, the only knockdown of the fight. Here's Johnny with the decision.
Rodriguez was penalized the sixth round for striking low. Judge Frank Forbes scores it 5-3, 2-even, Rodriguez. Referee Teddy Martin has a 5-4-1, Rodriguez. Judge Adi Aydala has it 6-3, 1-even, Rodriguez. Given by unanimous decision, Rodriguez.
First defeat of his professional career, but believe me, there's no disgrace to lose to Rodriguez, and it was a close fight, as you can see by the doubt in the officials' cards. Among them, they had four rounds even. No fight next week. Instead, a special program, The World's Girls, but be at television ringside 2 weeks from tonight, and enjoy the 10-round middleweight match between Florentino Fernandez and Rocky Rivero from Madison Square Garden on the Fight of the Week. Produced by Hugh Beach. Directed by Marshall Diskin. Associate Director Bill Lilling. Technical Director Lou Marchand. Stay tuned now for Make That Spare, which follows immediately over most of these ABC stations. Until next Friday, this is Don Dunphy saying goodnight to your hosts, Robert Fern Cigarillos, the change of pace smoke, and Gillette, maker of the slim adjustable razor, super blue blades, foamy shaving cream, Right Guard power spray deodorant, and Sun Up aftershave.